Hello everyone, welcome back and welcome to viewers. Today we're doing instrument panels. First of all, let's talk about what an instrument panel can do for you. Just as a quick little example here, I've got four dials. You can have four dials that take up four blocks go into a one block. The same thing for also toggle switches, lights, things like that can go into an instrument panel, and it can save you a lot of space in your cockpits and make your designs look a lot cleaner and a lot more useful. So that's pretty much it. You know, we'll get into more of it as we start connecting things up to it and showing you how it goes. But this is literally what it does. It just kind of reduces the amount of blocks that you have to use and gives you a better readout here. So let's go ahead and get rid of all these. All right, so the first thing we're going to have to do is we're going to have to come up here and we're going to have to do microcontroller editor. We're going to kind of set up a microcontroller today that will allow you to just have one microcontroller for all these things that the instrument panel can do. We'll leave things unconnected and stuff, and you'll kind of see how it goes, and you'll just be able to plop this down onto a build, hook up what you need to it, and then all I have to do is add a few nodes to get it working. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to have to change the shape of this a little bit. Let's skinny it up here. And we're gonna make it six long here. We're gonna hop over to the logic, and we're just gonna plop down two composites here. One in, one out, and all this will make sense later. Output, let's go ahead and label this output. All right, that's all labeled. Make sure you label your stuff, otherwise things will get really confusing if you don't start labeling things. All right, so now that we've done that, we're gonna jump into the logic, and we're gonna kind of make this cleaned up a little bit. So we'll spread this one out over here. We'll spread this one out over here. We've got our ins and outs now. The first thing we're gonna need is a composite read number. That's what we're gonna start with here. Composite read number. We're gonna need four of these actually. Four, and all that does is this is gonna allow us, because there's four spots on the instrument panel. So that's, think of those as channels, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So each position on that instrument panel has a channel number. So that's what we're going to do here. We're going to change these. So this one's already set for channel 1. So this one's going to read channel 2. This one's going to read channel 3. And this one's going to read channel 4. Now, they do have the ability to go up to 32. That gives 8 channels per position on the instrument panel. And that's for stuff later on down the road. We're not going to get into that today. Let's just worry about channels 1 through 4 and getting some things hooked up to this. All right, now that we've got that, we're also going to get a composite read on off. We're gonna do the same thing. We want four of those, just like that. We're just gonna move this out a little bit, and we're gonna do connect this composite all the way up through all of these. That way, it can read all of these. All right, so we're now set up. So let's jump back out. We're gonna save this. Let's go back over to our properties microcontroller. We're gonna call this instrument panel AIO. We'll call this an all-in-one. And apparently, some of my keys are not working on my keyboard here. All right, so we've got that. That's not, why are my keys not working? And then they're double clicking. Awesome, what a fun thing that is. So we'll copy, we'll paste it there. That way when we actually search instrument panel or AIO, this will pop up for us. We're gonna save that. We're gonna save it as the same thing, instrument panel AIO, all in one, and we're good to go here. So let's jump back. All right, so we've got the left side figured out. Now let's get the right side figured out. So we'll have our ins and our outs, and then you can use this for however you need to go. So on this side, we're gonna need a composite write number and a composite write on off. And this is pretty simple here. What we're gonna do is we're gonna feed this composite into this one and then this one. The next thing that we need to change is the channel count. Because we're only using four things, we're gonna do a channel count of four on both of these. And we're going to stick with the default channel starting out on one. This will all make sense a little bit, and you'll kind of understand what's going on. Now we're set up for ins and outs on this microcontroller. So let's go ahead and save that, and we're good to go. Now we can start putting some stuff down and figuring out which side this needs to go onto. So let's get out of here. Let's update that. All right, so now that we're all set up for both sides, let's go ahead and start figuring out how to do some of these things. Let's leave it on dials for now, and let's get some things for these dials to read. Say we got a tank here, so we can read some fuel. Let's go with an altimeter sensor here, and let's see if we can find a couple other things to stick in here and read some of that. Grab a temperature probe and your speed sensor, whatever. We're just going to grab some things. You'll understand how these all work, and we'll go from there. So you notice they all have a output node. So we're gonna come into the microcontroller, gonna edit it, add some logic. We're gonna spread our logic out here. And for the sake of this, we're gonna name these 1, 2, 3, and 4 because of channel numbers, and that'll be easier for us to understand what's going on. Since they were all number outputs, we're gonna change these all to numbers. All right, so we had our four items out there that all had number outputs. So now we have number inputs here for our microcontroller. So let's go into the logic. And now, because we've already set things up, we kind of can just figure out where things go. And because of the nodes here, we know that those are only going to connect up to this type of input. And that kind of just makes all this obsolete at this point. So we can just come in here. Let's 1, 2, 3, and 4. So let's put these in the right order so everyone understands what's going on. 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to connect these up to 1, 2, 3, and 4. Simple as that. And because we've already connected everything else up, we're good to go. So all we have to do is save and update that. We'll come back out to our logic and we can start putting these up to here. And there we go. So yeah, don't forget to add power to your builds. I do this quite often. Things need power. Okay, after you add power, we're gonna get the select tool and we're gonna come in here and we're gonna change these up. Because remember we were talking about they were on different channels. And all we're gonna do is remember is 1, 2, 3, 4 is how we're looking at this right now. We're gonna come in 1, 2, 3, and 4. So that tells whatever comes in here, it comes into the microcontroller and then it sends it out through the composite signal and then it rereads it. Okay, this is channel 1, it's hooked up to this. This is channel 2, it's hooked up to this, so on and so on. Let's spawn that in, give that a look. Don't forget to hook up your composite. All right, and so now here we go. We've got all our items from over here. Temperature is 21. There's the temperature there. That's probably our altimeter. We're probably 14 above, and our gas tank is 31. I think that's right. And we're getting 0 on the speed. So yeah, that's correct there. Okay, so that's how to take number inputs into the controller and send them out to the instrument panel. All right, let's switch this up. Let's get some switches on here and see what's going on. Okay, so now I've placed down 4 toggles here, and the toggles have a different output. So that means we've got to come in here and change these to be something that represents these. So what we're going to do here is we're going to come over first to our instrument panel, and because you can't read a switch to a dial, we're going to turn these into indicators. Just like this. And we've already got our channel number set up, so we don't have to change anything there. Indicator, 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 indicator. All right, so now we're gonna come into our microcontroller. We're gonna edit it. Yes, we wanna edit. And all we're gonna do is turn these into on-offs. Simple as that. On-off, on-off, on-off. Because each one of those toggles is sending out an on-off signal, and then we'll be able to read that through our instrument panel. Let's come over to the logic. Nothing's changed other than we're not hooked up here, and we're just going to slide this down. 1 to 1, 2 to 2, 3 to 3, and 3 to 4. No, 1 to 1, 2 to 2, 3 to 3, and 4 to 4. And we're already hooked up through here. It'll read straight through this without a problem. You don't have to change anything here, and we could get some activity on our instrument panel that way. Update, always update. We're going to come into here. We're going to hook up our switches here, just like so. I'm going to check our composite. Composite's still hooked up. Electricity is hooked up to what matters. Let's hook all that up. And let's spawn this in and see if this works. All right, so now, if I can stand still on this, we've got indicators here that would let you know if something is turned on or not. So we're going to come through and flip these switches. As you can see, for each switch that we turn on, it turns on a light and lets us know something's working. This doesn't have to be a toggle just to turn on a light. This could just be a system that's reading an on signal. Say like your landing gear is down. It would let you know if it's down or up, or there's so many different things you can use for this, but this is just to show you the way that the logic flows through here. Okay, so that's on off signals. Let's jump back in and see if we can get this other side going. All right, so what we're going to do here is we're going to change these up again. And let's change this up to say a button, and we're going to use different buttons here, because they all look different, but they can do the same thing here. So we're gonna use an arrow button. And with this, you can change which direction it goes, which is nice if you wanna do something that's left and right controlled or up and down controlled. You're gonna make a small winch control, things like that. That's what this is for. Come down to 3, we'll make this a flip switch. And the last one can be, I think we only have four different types of buttons. Maybe only three. Arrow button, button, gauge, indicator, dial. Yep. Okay, so we'll just do another flip switch. Make sure the composite channels are right. 1, 2, 3, 4. We're good there. But let's get ourselves something that this can indicate and show us what's going on. So we'll need a light. Now, again, this doesn't have to be lights. This could be, say, your landing gear. This could be you flipping landing gear up and down, or flaps, or flooding a submarine. Whatever you need it to do, this is just to show you that how it works through this. So we're going to go back to our logic. Okay, first of all, we're going to hook it all up to power. Not a problem. We're going to go to our logic here. Obviously, we need some outputs, so we're going to change this to have outputs. We'll come into our design here. All we have to do is change output, 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 and output. And there we go. We'll come back into the logic. And now, because we're all set up, all we've got to do is slide back over to this side and connect things up. Now, it won't always be this neat where it's just, you know, sometimes it will. Sometimes you'll just have them all grouped up into one area. Sometimes you'll have one here, two here, none here, or whatever. It can be all mixed up. But that's what's nice about this is once you set it up, you plop in your logic, and then it's all just kind of right there in front of your face. You don't have to go, well, do I need a composite right or composite? It takes a lot of the confusion out once you have this set up the way it is. So we're hooked up here. We're going to update the microcontroller. We're going to come back, hook up our logic here. Easy enough. Double check our composite's still here. Double check our power. Spawn it in. All right, so now we have our switches here. And as we turn them on, it's going to turn on our lights and show you that it is working from here. So, all of them are lit up. You know what we didn't do? We need to come over here and all channel one. So when we were turning on that first switch, it was reading it for all of these. So we're just going to come in here and change these. 3 and 4. And that should take care of that problem. Update it. Spawn it in again. 9 times out of 10, when I'm trying to debug stuff with composites, my channel numbers are wrong. That's 9 times out of 10 what I come across, and I'm like, why is this not working? Go check your channel numbers. Go check your channel numbers. Go check your channel numbers. From there, you go check composite, then check your power. Let's see if that fixed it. Okay, we've got the first one on. Say we're turning our landing gear. Yep, and we want other systems on. Perfect. So that could be how that's done. This could also be a push button for starting an engine, so to speak. So you'd push, hold, engine's cranked up. You let go, and your engine's running, and then you can have an indicator light underneath here to let you know that that engine is actually running and operating. Just some ideas there. Let's jump back in. Let's get rid of these. So that works. Let's get rid of all these lights here. So with this setup, hopefully you can make some easy instrument panels and kind of start understanding what's going on with this and start using them. I struggled with them, so hopefully this helps you guys out. So I will be continuing this series. We will be figuring some things out. We are going to check out the 7 segment, the radial segment, and the bar segment in the next episode. I figured if we covered the first few here, the dial, indicator, gauge, button, arrow button, and flip switch, once you can get past those, it's pretty easy to start understanding where these go. But this is going to be a whole nother segment here, pun intended. To get these done and to start understanding what's going on. So if you don't understand how to do these, then you're not going to understand how to do these. But hopefully I've helped you out here. Hopefully this is enough for you to understand what's going on. And if you start copying this microcontroller, you can just slap this down and use it on anything. So I hope that helps. Let me know down in the comments what you guys think. If this did help you out, throw a like on it. Subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. Share this with your friends. Let them use this. I don't care. This is for everybody. That helps out as far as a little bit of the instrument panels go, and we will be jumping in later to do the other segments that have a little bit more complexity to them. Guys, thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next one.